We can see that the bulb has lit here. So we can see that the bulb has lit now. I'm going to zoom in and see what's happening here. It's possible to see in there, you can see at the left hand electrode we have bubbling taking place. If I wet some universal indicator paper, you can see at the left hand electrode we've got bubbling, effervescence, there's a gas clearly being produced. I can see that it's a brown gas, you may not be able to make that out. Take some damp indicator paper, place it over towards that side. We might see that it's an acidic gas. You can see it beginning to turn reddish there. So it's certainly an acidic gas. If you leave it for long enough, it will bleach the paper. So certainly gas being produced at the left-hand electrode, the anode. Over at the right-hand electrode, it's not clear at this stage, but perhaps when we withdraw the electrode from the electrolyte, we might see a shiny appearance of a liquid metal, a grey metal, which would be the lead. You may just about make out plumes of a brown gas. That's the bromine being produced at the left side, left-hand electrode. You can just see them there. Clouds of brown bromine gas being produced, very poisonous gas. This needs to be done on a fume cupboard. No such bubbling immediately around the right hand electrode. Around the right hand electrode, that's where we're getting the lead produced. In a few moments I'll withdraw the electrodes, hoping to see some signs that maybe lead has been produced around the right hand electrode, the cathode. So this is the electrolysis of molten lead to bromide, using inert graphite electrodes. We're seeing bubbling effervescence at the left-hand electrode, the anode, where bromide ions are undergoing oxidation. 2Br- produces Br2, a molecule of bromine, plus two electrons. Those electrons travel up through that left-hand electrode, the anode. They go up through the circuit, through the battery, and come around to this right-hand electrode, the cathode. Lead ions are attracted into the right-hand electrode, the cathode, where they accept electrons and undergo reduction, therefore. The half equation at the right-hand electrode is Pb2 plus 2E- gives Pb. Lead 2 plus ions are changing into lead atoms. And we should see a pool of silver metal as lead melts just above 300, and it's hotter in there than that. The half equation at the left hand electrode, the anode, is 2Br- produces Br2 plus 2E-. The bromine gas, highly poisonous, will eventually bleach the paper. I'm going to pull back with the camera for a moment. And what I'm going to do here is I turn off the heat for a moment so that I can get in a little bit closer. If you pan out, you can see that the bulb is still on. I'm supplying electricity direct current using a power pack set at 9 volts. You can see the brown bromine gas being produced at the left-hand electrode. Again, this needs to be done on a fume cover because of the highly poisonous nature of bromine. And I'm going to withdraw the electrodes here, hoping to see some sign on the right-hand electrode of lead, silvery metal, molten lead. Difficult to see, but perhaps you can make out some vague signs of lead being produced. Down at the bottom of the dish, we'll see possibly some lead as well. We'll lift this with tongs. Pour the molten electrolyte in here. There are some signs of a lead deposit around the dish, the bottom of the dish there. You may see some shiny particles of lead has been produced. Okay, and that completes our look at the electrolysis of molten lead to bromide.